Perforin Granzyme Apoptosis Pathway, Creative Diagnostics. Perforin Granzyme Apoptosis Pathway is the primary signaling pathway used by cytotoxic lymphocytes to eliminate virus-infected and/or transformed cells. Studies in gene-disrupted mice indicate that perforin, in combination with granzyme, could induce apoptosis. It is vital for cytotoxic effector function and has an indispensable, but an undefined role in granzyme-mediated apoptosis. We are going to mainly focus on five parts to talk about perforin granzyme apoptosis pathway. First of all, how about perforin and granzyme? Perforin is a pore-forming protein and also known as cytoplasmic granule toxins. Granzyme is a family of structurally related serine proteases stored within the cytotoxic granules of cytotoxic lymphocytes. Perforin and granzyme induce target cell apoptosis cooperatively. Granzyme is necessary for triggering apoptosis of target cells, but they depend on being appropriately delivered by perforin. Both perforin and granzyme bind to the target cell surface as part of a single macromolecular complex associated with sirglycine, which further diminishes the probability of passive diffusion of granzymes. In humans, there are granzyme A, B, H, K, and M. Once secreted by cytotoxic lymphocytes, granzymes enter into target cells, which is a vital step in cell death. The major lytic proteins packaged within the granules are different granzymes and the pore-forming protein perforin, which facilitates the internalization of granzymes by cells. In cytoplasm, granzyme B activates BID. BID together with BAX and BAC proteins result in the leakage of cytochrome C into the cytosol. Cytochrome C release activates procaspase 9, and by binding to apoptotic protease of PF1, procaspase 9 becomes mature caspase 9, which continues to form the apoptosome and activates caspase 3. Activated caspase 3 is able to cleave specific substrates like ICAD, allowing the CAD to translocate to the nucleus to fragment DNA. Besides BID, granzyme B can inactivate MCL1, which is a member of the anti-apoptotic BCL2 family, to release BIM. And granzyme B can also mediate the effector caspase 3 and initiator caspase 8 to regulate the apoptosis pathway. Contrast to granzyme B, granzyme M doesn't dependent on mitochondrial to regulate, but granzyme M may activate granzyme B by the cleavage PI9. Granzyme M also can directly cleave the ICAD to unleash CAD like granzyme B. The granzyme induces loss of mitochondrial inner membrane potential and the release of reactive oxygen species ROS in response to ROS, the ER-associated set complex, including SET, APE1, PP32, HMG2 and TREX1. They translocate to the nucleus, where TREX1, HM23H1, CAD, lamin are involved in DNA fragmentation. The perforin pathway is involved intimately in defense against viral pathogens and transformed cells. Perforin is instrumental in the pathogenesis of certain autoimmune disease models, such as insulin-dependent diabetes and non-obese diabetic NOD mice, but it might suppress other autoimmune diseases, including experimental autoimmune encephalomyelitis. The perforin/granzyme apoptosis pathways that regulate granule polarization and exocytosis are being determined, and these pathways might be disrupted by the interaction of cancer cells with some cytotoxic lymphocytes. Any questions? Do not hesitate to contact us. Email us at info@creative-diagnostics.com. Our website. Thank you.